Hello and welcome to this PalmSense video. And today we're going to talk about electrodes, especially about screen printed electrodes. We're offering a lot of third-party electrodes. We get often questions about which electrodes to choose and why, especially when it comes to screen printed electrodes. So let's have a look at common electrodes that people use for measurements and focus there on the working electrodes. So these are the very common electrodes that most people know. These are metal discs that are surrounded by some kind of polymer. I think this is KLF. So usually it's an inert polymer that's very chemically resistant, so it doesn't interfere with your measurement. And then you have an exposed metal disc that's polished to mirror shine, and common materials are gold and platinum. And another typical material is glassy carbon, which is glass-like carbon. So it's a carbon species, but you basically can polish it and use it like a metal. So these are three very popular types of working electrodes. And they all kind of exist as screen-printed electrodes as well. Let's first say what's the difference between these electrodes, screen-printed electrodes, and then we also have these kind of thin-film electrodes. So these electrodes have really metal discs in there that are then polished to mirror shine. While screen print electrodes are made from conducting inks. So usually these inks contain some kind of binder polymer, so basically a glue, some organic solvent to keep the glue liquid. And in the whole mixture, they are the conducting particles dissolved. So this can be graphite particles for most of the carbon species. This can be gold particles or platinum particles for having metal electrodes in the end. So the surface structure is really fundamentally different from these, where you have a pure metal. Because once the inks have been printed, they get cured, which basically dissolve the organic solvent. And then you have a blob of polymer with these conducting particles in there. So the surface will be different. And usually not all of the surface area is then electrochemically active, because parts of it is just, well, the polymer block. Okay, so that's the difference. But then we have a third type of electrodes that is done by some companies. So these companies would be the teeny tiny electrodes here from the company Microx, which are metal deposited on glass, and then it's deposited by vapor deposition. So they put the glass slides into a vacuum and they heat up a metal that this way becomes gaseous. And because the glass slides are colder than the heated up metal sample, the metal is depositing on them. This way you get a thin metal film. So it still is more like a metal electrode. The behavior is not always 100% the same, but it's closer to traditional metal. Also, companies like G-Sense, they do a different way of doing it, and BVT usually uses also some kind of vapor deposition or these kind of deposition methods. Companies like Italsense, for example, they stick to conducting inks. With Zimmer and Peacock, they have different versions, but most of the electrodes are screen printed. And the company Microx, which made these small electrodes, also offer their thick film electrodes, which are then screen printed. These are the kind of three types of electrodes you can get. Let's talk about materials on the electrodes, because sometimes we get from customers the question, well, should I use gold or should I use carbon or should I use platinum? The answer is, most of the times, we don't really know, because it depends really specific on your applications. There are a few applications where definitely some metals are better or some materials are better than others. A classic example for gold is many biosensors that work with a covalent bonding like to use gold, because you can easily make a connection between your organic molecules and the gold surface if you have thiol groups. So these are sulfur, hydrogen, and then some organic rest. This way you can get easily your enzymes bound or your DNA bound to the gold surface. So often these types of electrodes are popular with electrodes where people want to covalently bound their biorecognition element to the electrode. So that's the advantage of gold. The disadvantage of gold is that it's like to collect organic material from the air. For example, also there are sulfur compounds. So often gold requires an electropolishing step before you can use it. So it's a bit more work to use gold, but it's popular because you can easily modify it with organic molecules. Platinum is usually more for the classic electrodes a choice because platinum has the advantage it does very little reactions on its own. So the platinum does not react with something else. So it's usually good if you just want to look at a species in solution, you don't want to have any other interfering ions, etc. It has a wide window where it is stable, but it does catalyze water splitting. And that also includes hydrogen peroxide splitting. So platinum is popular in applications where you want to detect hydrogen peroxide, for example, or where you are happy with water splitting happening at a bit lower potentials. But we're talking like going from like 1.4 to 1.2 volts. So it's not drastically lower, but it can be helpful. And this is why platinum is very popular as a counter electrode, because it does not release any ions that make it difficult for interferences with your other reactions, and it allows water splitting more easier, so you don't have to think that much about your counter-electrode reaction. Carbon is, as a material, it has a lot of variations because you have graphite, you have carbon black, you have classic carbon, you have graphene, and at the same time, you have boron-doped diamond. Of course, I was thinking diamond is not conductive, but if you dope it with boron, then it becomes conductive and it also gives electrodes with interesting properties. Regular carbon electrodes have the advantage that the materials are cheap. Carbon black is basically some form of soot, so it's a bit easy. It's very cheap to get it, so they're a bit cheaper to make than using noble metals. So that's an advantage of carbon and why many people strive for carbon. The other thing is carbon has a lot of surface functionalities and you can influence them. If you put a carbon electrode into an oxidizing environment and maybe help by applying an oxidizing potential, you create carboxylic groups and indole groups and alcohols on the surface, making it easy to have interactions with other species. Or maybe you just want to work with adsorption. So you, for example, you just want to drop an enzyme on it and hope it sticks. And then carbon is great because it offers a lot of interactions. But carbon has the disadvantage that, for example, gas evolution is usually requiring a high overpotential. So on your counter electrode, if you have not designed any reaction for your counter electrode, usually it is water splitting. And in other, well, usually platinum does a good job at water splitting. Carbon does a bad job at water splitting, and you need high potentials there at your counter electrode. Coming back to carbon, let's quickly talk about the different species. So most electrodes use graphite as the basic material. We offer one type of electrodes that have a very special material, and that are the G-Sense electrodes from the company Integrated Graphene, which have 3D graphene foam material, which is also made by growing it on the electrode and not depositing it there or printing it there. So this is a very special material. It has very low charge transfer resistance. It is very conductive. This carbon species almost behave like metal, but it is more complicated to make it. So let's say compared to other carbon species electrode, they're slightly more expensive. These are general comments I can make about the electrodes. And of course, there are different applications that work better with other electrodes. Another example is radicals. If you want to deposit a polymer by forming radicals with carbon, it will nicely react with a carbon interface and form covalent bonding. While on platinum, it's more likely is that you will have a polymer formed block on your platinum surface that you can again like wash away or rub off. Again, depending a bit exactly on the experiment you do. So this is a very general guide. You still will have most likely for every experiment that you're running or for every project to evaluate which material is the best. Plus, keep in mind, as I said, screen printed electrodes are made from inks. Different inks have different polymers in there, have different ratios of conducting material to polymer binder and maybe to organic solvent during the printing process. Maybe temperatures or humidities are different during the curing process. Every company's electrodes are different. So if you buy carbon electrodes from Italsense, they may show a different behavior than the ones from Microx or Zimmer and Peacock. And which one is the best for your experiments depend a bit what type of experiment you have. Some of them work very well for certain enzymes to absorb, others don't. Some of them work very well then for forming polymers on them. So it always depends on very detailed specifications. My general advice would be to, well, shop around, so to try different electrodes for your applications and see which ones work best. I hope that gives you some guidance in how to choose your electrodes. And if you found that video helpful, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on LinkedIn so you don't miss any of our updates. Also, you can find a lot of tutorial videos or webinars in our knowledge base on our website. You can find a link in the description below. Thanks for watching. And have a great day.